check electrical charge. Get the cobwebs out of it. I use pliers to undo capacitor terminals because sometimes they hold charge. And there's that very small percentage that you could get shocked, but most likely no, but it's part of my habit now. Part of my process. This meter's 4 years old now, and it's getting slower and slower.
So how is the capacitor?
It's just fine. Mm-hmm. And these units are a year and a half, 2 years old, so just fine. It's rated at 4510, 7510. And then I always check how tight the wires are, wiring connections are too, because loose wires can trip breakers, burn up wires, burn up lugs. And we actually got a couple turns on that one, so I'll check them in the disconnect too. But there's still voltage to this, so you want to use an insulated screwdriver and not stick your finger on the shaft. But these are all pretty tight. That's pretty much all I check. I'll check amperage, you know, once I start it back up.
Okay.
Then we'll put gauges on it. Make sure I hooked everything back up before I start turning it back on. We have 57 amps on startup. So it's starting nice and smooth. Is 125, so we're way under that. 9 amps when it's running. Well under. We'll check our fan. 124, which is fine. On older units, you don't want to rely just on the sticker. You always want to look on the motor, because the motor could have been changed. But. No, this is 2 years old, so I can trust this. 1.7 is the maximum amperage, so we're well under. And I like to shut it off when I'm putting the door back on it, because one little slip, you know, you could shock yourself. We should see something a little higher than 40.
Okay.
And just kind of how that compressor sounds, kind of making that like patter noise, yeah. Ticking noise. We will want to come back on a warmer day and check it when there's an actual load on the hallway, humidity to remove and things like that. So we'll just notate that, come back.